Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Jamie B. Thanks for stopping by. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a Wet n Wild bronzer versus my Charlotte Tilbury bronzer and just give you guys a comparison and my thoughts on whether or not you should pay the price for the Charlotte Tilbury or go with a cheaper alternative. So if you're excited or wondering what the difference are they the same? Go ahead and keep on watching. Even though we're working on doing a bronzer versus bronzer, just ignore the fact that my eyes are half done because I am also filming a different video for you guys. But what we're here for. So today we're gonna try out two different bronzers. I thought, why the freak not? These are two of my favorite bronzers, but they are on two different aspects of the price field, okay? This is a Wet n Wild bronzer, and this is just, I think it's just bronzer, Queensland, and it is $4.99. And then this is my Charlotte Tilbury bronzer. It's the airbrush bronzer in shade 3, and this bronzer is $55. So what we're doing today basically is you guys are going to get ready with me with my face makeup. I'm going in with my Milk Makeup Hydro Grip, and we're gonna test it out, man. We're gonna see, because like I said, they are both my favorite bronzers, okay? So I love them both. They both do amazing. And I just wanna see them side by side. I have a lot of fun doing these like dupey this versus that videos. So if you guys like this, I'm also going in with my Tatcha Silk Canvas for like my pore area. But if you guys like these kind of things where I just kind of like test expensive versus inexpensive, then definitely let me know down below. All right, so I put that on my really dry and rough areas just to smooth it out a little bit. And today I'm using my new Pretty Vulgar foundation in the shade 43. This is the Cool AF Water Lava Foundation. I've never used it before. I'm going in with my Laura Lee foundation brush, which is my favorite foundation brush ever. Okay, hopefully it's not too dark because I haven't even, no, might be a little too yellow, but I feel like I can work with this. Oh my God, I went right over my eyebrow. Oh, it is a little yellow, okay. Pretty runny foundation, actually. It doesn't feel very heavy. I'm assuming because it's a water lava, it's supposed to be like a thinner consistency. It feels like that just went a long way. The two pumps that I just put on my face, because I've already done my neck. So like, wow. And I'm sorry if my eyebrows look like today, because for some reason they're just not doing what I need them to do. Like, I just don't know. So for today's concealer, I'm going in with the Revolution Conceal and Define Infinite Longwear Concealer. And this is in C10.2. I'm just going to put it down here and a little bit here and down here. This shade is actually really beautiful. Like this foundation shade, I think it actually looks really good with my skin. It's a little yellow toned. I'm a little more neutral than this, but it's not terrible. I feel like in the summertime, it's definitely gonna look so good when I warm up. So with me, with my skin, it's so crazy. Like in the summertime, I'll be really, really cool toned, more like neutral. And then in the summertime, I get a little bit more neutral golden. It's so weird. And that's why when I was going through my makeup, organizing it the other day, Steven's like,
why do you have so many foundations? Why are they different colors?
I'm sitting here like, okay, well, you know, not all of us can just be one single shade all year long. Some of us have issues with our skin, you know, just changing, shifting. Like my skin is so weird, where it won't just change in the summer and the fall. My skin will change in the spring. It just depends how much sun I'm getting. And like, I'm really, 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 really paler this year because of the pandemic. I really haven't gone anywhere. I haven't really left, not even to go to work. So I'm definitely more fair when it comes to that. But no, he just doesn't get it. So I decided I'm gonna go in with my Kylie setting powder today. I always go with my Charlotte Tilbury or my Milk Makeup, and I was like, I wanna try to change it up a little. So I'm going in with the Kylie translucent setting powder. Okay. Ooh. Okay, I love this. I love this setting powder for me. I don't know why, I really do. Now we're gonna go into the bronzer. So this side of my face is gonna be Charlotte Tilbury. This side of my face is going to be Wet n Wild. I'm excited. I'm going to be using the same brush just to make sure it's fair. And I have a color switch here to clean it and make sure none of the residue of either is on it. All right, so we're gonna go in with the $4.99 bronzer first. And I'm just gonna do what I would normally do. A couple little swirls. This one doesn't have too much fallout, but it definitely does have some fallout. Okay. I just love this color. But I definitely, now that I'm putting it on right now, I remember, like, I have to dip into it quite often to achieve. Now, if you want just a regular bronze, like light bronze look, I think that this is gonna be something you enjoy. I just bring a little bit here. I don't do a lot here, I just do a little. Just give me a little shadow. So I definitely feel like I had to go really ham, and it's still giving me a little bit of some patchiness, no matter how I kind of like do that. So that's a thing. Okay. It doesn't look terrible though. It doesn't look terrible. It's definitely cinching my face in and giving me that bronzy look. Now we're gonna go in with $55 bronzer. Let me clean this brush off before I do that. You definitely get a lot more in this one, but still don't know that $55 is where it's at. So I'm just color changing, so there's no cheating. And I'm just gonna do a little couple swirls in here. And this one has a little bit more fallout actually than that one does. And we're just gonna go in. Do you see? Okay. That definitely went on way more than the Wet n Wild did. However, I will definitely say this one's kind of patchy too. This one has a little more red in it. It's definitely kind of patchy too. And this one kind of sticks to my texture a little bit more. I will not lie to you. So I'm going in again because I feel like this definitely does have some patchiness going on. I think I put too much this time. And I'm putting some down here, just a smidge. Okay, so I definitely feel like this is a darker bronzer, and I can never get up here bronze. Like, it's definitely, there's bronzer there, but for some reason, it doesn't come off on camera. All right, so I feel like, I'm not gonna lie, this actually feels way more patchy if you look here versus here. And I keep trying to blend it out, but it really doesn't. I love the color. And I love the feel of this one, but again, it does stick to my texture a lot more now that I'm seeing them side by side. They look so similar. Like $55, $4.99. Oh, that's so crazy to me. All right, so I'm gonna clean the brush again because I'm gonna try to get this one to be a little bit more like oomph, like this one. So, and I've had this one for a long time, by the way. But it is one of my favorite bronzers. Oh, there we go, there we go. So it takes a little bit more for this one, but at the end of the day, $4.99, even if I'd have to buy this thing 10 times to even touch the other one. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and bronze my nose with this one just because I have it in my hand, and I don't think I'd be able to bronze my nose with both of them with the way that I bronze my nose. All right, so let's move on to the blush and the rest of it. But I really feel like, I don't know where I stand right now. Like, I just feel like, I don't know. I could have gotten, like, look at that. They look almost exactly the same. Let me know if you guys see a difference down below. So I'm going in with a NYX Ombre blush in the shade Soft Flush. And I'm just going to go through and put it on like usual. This is an orangish blush. It's actually extremely orange. But when I put it on for some reason, like every other blush, it just looks pink. Like, I don't know what that is. It's like an orangey, pinky brush. Blush. I love blush. I love it. And then we're gonna move into highlighter. I'm going in with a Kylie highlighter in the shade Queen Drip. Give it a nice glow. It's more of like a pinky, peachy color, like the undertone reflex. So I really like this one. And then we're gonna go into lips. Today I'm using a lot of Kylie today. I'm trying to incorporate makeup that I have and haven't used in a while into my videos and just basically all around makeup routine because I feel like a lot of my makeup is just sitting there getting old and stale. So this is 22 by Kylie. It's a orangey color. I felt like it would really go with that orangey brown I have on the top of my eyes right here. It actually looks really gorgeous with this look. Ooh, I love this. All right, so I'm gonna spray on my setting spray. I love this stuff. I did a video on this whole company that they sent me a PR box. It's Pop Beauty. This was actually one of my favorite items that they sent me. Like, my face feels super cakey once I use all those powders and I spray this on, and immediately I just feel like a like loosening and lift in my face. I love this stuff. All right, so I'm gonna hop off camera real quick and I'm going to throw on my eyelashes and then I will be right back. Alright guys, so my final thoughts on the bronzers. I feel like they performed very similar. I will say for what it's 55, it did take me less to put on to achieve this. However, it was still kind of patchy. I mean, I have dry skin. So I feel like if you don't have dry skin, you're probably not gonna have that patchy situation with either of these. But because I do have dry texture skin, I do have patchy situation going on for both. But when I look in that mirror over there, I will definitely say this one does have more color, where this one is kind of like more light and blended in with my skin. So if you can see the difference here, and here, and then on the forehead as well. So I will definitely say that this is a better bronzer, okay? For $55, it had better be a better bronzer. With that being said, I think that this is an amazing bronzer. For $4.99, I'm getting almost the exact same effect and look as a $55 Charlotte Tilbury bronzer. So if you want to save money, then just go to your local drugstore and get a Wet n Wild bronzer. If you want to splurge, then go ahead and get the Charlotte Tilbury. I do love it, but will I pay $55 for a bronzer again? Probably not. I just think that they're both very, very much my favorite bronzers, but they're both very, very much on two different sides of the money spectrum. $55, I can get 10 of these for the price of one of these. So if I had to pick one, like do or die, it's gonna be my Wet n Wild. I love this bronzer. I have used this bronzer many, many times. And I mean, it shows, like the whole decorative part of it is kind of gone, but it still has a lot of life left. Like I still haven't hit pan on this. So save yourself all that moolah and get this one. But that is it for today's video, guys, in the comparison versus a luxury product and a drugstore product. I honestly really had a lot of fun. I don't know that I've ever actually done a video like this. I've had a lot of fun comparing them, so I hope you guys liked it. If you did, go ahead and comment down below some things that you want to see compared to luxury items versus drugstore items, and I will get those up for you. I do not have a lot of drugstore makeup, but I am in the process of kind of reaching out more for drugstore stuff to be able to compare them, find good dupes for you guys, and all that fun stuff. So if you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Make sure you comment down below and let me know, do you feel the same? Did they do similar? Do you think that one did better than the other? Always let me know what you guys think, because your thoughts and your opinions are super important to me. Make sure you're subscribed to my channel. I do 5 beauty videos every week and 1 blooper video every Saturday. And as always, guys, I'll see you on the next one. Bye.